God sees us naked before him. We don't have to have no condemnation, no nothing when we come to the throne, because he knows us. He knows our heart. He knows all about us. So Lord Father, we come to you this morning in the name of your precious son, Jesus. We come lifting you up today, Lord, praising your name and glorifying you and worshiping you, because you are worthy. You alone are worthy for your goodness, your mercy, and your grace. For what you did for us, oh God, the love that you had for us and the love that you still have for us, even when we slip and fall, God, you are there to pick us up. Lord, we thank you for that today. We thank you, Lord, that you wake us up in the night and we can come to you anytime and you never sleep nor slumber. You are always there to embrace us when we feel we are alone. You are always there when we feel that we are at rock bottom. You are there to lift us up. When the doctor has said, we won't make it, but you are there saying, I am the healer. In the courtroom, when the jury say you are guilty, you said you're not guilty. Oh God, you Lord, when the devil reminds us of our past, we can turn around and remind him of his future. God, we thank you today, Lord. We thank you today, because no matter what happens, we serve a living God. You are not dead. You are alive. Yes. And you are all powerful. You are almighty. Yes. You are all seeing. You know everything, oh God.
Hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah to your name. God, we thank you today. We just want to reverence your name today, Lord. And we want you to have your way in this service, Lord. Oh, Father God, bring that fire down, Lord. Burn up everything in us that's not of you, Lord. Let us not be the same when we leave here today, God. It's not the time to be playing church. We want to be serious, Lord. We want to be serious about you, Lord. Because we thank you, Lord, that even in our sin, you loved us and sent your son to die for us. So, Lord, we thank you today. And we just turn the service over to you, Lord. We expect to see signs and wonders and miracles. We expect to see your glory. Fill this place with your presence today, Lord. With this your presence today, God, fill this place. And Lord, we thank you. And bless our pastor as he comes out with your word, Lord. Bless him, oh God. Have your way in him, Lord. Woo! Father, we thank you. We thank you and we praise you. We give all the glory and the honor and the praise to you. In Jesus' name, amen.
I'm trading my sin.
few minutes to just greet one another.
Said no. Aren't you glad that all the promises with the Lord are yes, yes. And amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Yeah. Woo. Yeah. Woo. Yeah. Woo.
Thank you.
possible. All things are possible.
All things are possible, even to the outgrowing of a limb, even to blind eyes being given sight, even for deaf ears to hear. All things are possible. There's nothing too hard for our God, brother. Nothing. That provision is coming to you. Because all things are possible. It may not look like it to you, but the Lord has a way that you do not know about. So don't give up, saith God. Trust in the Lord your God, for provision is truly on its way. Hallelujah!
Lord. Hallelujah!
And we've given up and we've lost our hope. But God is wanting the church to come with expectancy and believing that He is going to show up and manifest His glory to us. Amen? It's a new day, people. All things have passed away. We're in the new. And we want to step into it. Amen? Amen. So there's a preparation for us to do. Amen? Amen. And one of the things is changing our expectations. I'm right there with you. Right there with you. Always, always, always. Always, always. We all deal on the same things, just maybe different levels. Amen. Hallelujah. So we've come to worship the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords this morning. And we've come to reverence His presence and His anointing and His gifts. Amen? That's what we're to do. We're to come
morning. Because when we're in one accord, it's when the manifestation of God's presence is going to come. Amen? Hallelujah. We just worship you, Lord.
Come like the rain.
Show me your glory. face of the one that I love. Want to stay in your presence where I belong. Want to look on the face of the one that I love. Want to stay in your presence where I belong. Want to look on the face of the one that I love. Want to stay in your presence where I belong. Want to look on the face of the one that I love.
Thank you. God. I want every eye closed and every hand lifted up. I want you to open up your mouth and worship God for a moment. Everyone in this church. I don't want to hear your hands clapping. I just want to hear you worship God for a moment. Everyone in the room.
You are worthy, O God, to be exalted, to be worshipped, to be adored, O God.
I see you, Mario.
We do reverence you, praise, O God. We do reverence you, Father God, in your presence, O God. Your loving kindness is so much better than life.
You guys, I want you to step up in this front aisle right here.
We just worship
up here in the front
God.
Aisle.
Worship you, oh God.
Everybody in this
we
front aisle.
We exalt you, Lord. We exalt you, Lord Jesus. We exalt you. We exalt you for who you are, oh God. We glorify you, oh God, our God. You are an awesome God. You are doing great and mighty things in our midst, oh God. Father, we thank you, Lord God.
Praise God. Every voice lift it up.
You are God alone, oh God. That Father God, you are the King.
Every voice lift it up for a moment.
You are the wonderful Savior. You are the blessed Redeemer, oh God. You are the rock upon which I stand, oh God. You are the bright and the morning star, oh God. You are the Alpha. You are the Omega. You are the beginning. You are the end, oh God. You are the Lord, our God. You are the one who bought us. You are the one who saved us. You are the one who delivered us, oh God. You are the one, oh God.
Holy hands lifted up, oh
God. You are the one. You are the one.
Adonai, Adonai.
And only you, and only you are worthy, oh God.
Touch you from your feet to the top of your
yes,
head.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Let him touch you from your
thank
feet to the top
you,
of your head.
Thank you, Father.
Let him move on your back right now, your neck. Let him move in your blood right now. Let God touch you right now. Somebody's lungs are being touched right now. Somebody's back, God's ministering to you right now. Somebody's feet, somebody's heart is being touched right now by the power of the resurrection. Let him move on you right now. Let God touch you right now.
Woo, God.
chain, oh God.
Thank you, Lord.
Glory, glory.
Thank you, Jesus.
Oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father, new songs, oh God.
Thank you, Lord.
Songs of deliverance, oh God. Oh, songs of breakthrough, oh God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. 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 Glory, 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 glory.
Let the praises of God be.
Glory, 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 glory.
Let the praises of God be.
Glory, glory, glory. Glory to our God.
God be.
Glory to the Lord our God. Glory of the highest. Yes.
Oh, the glory.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Oh, the glory. Let your glory.
Hallelujah.
Let your glory fall.
Yes, God.
Let your glory fall, yes. Mighty God. Let
Hallelujah.
Your glory fall, Lord
Hallelujah.
Father God.
Yes.
I want everyone Hallelujah. In this church to lift your hands up, close your eyes, and I want you to open up your mouth, and I want you to worship God. If you've never done it before openly, I want you to do it right now. Hands over your head. Open up your mouth right now and worship God. Everyone in the room, worship God. Everyone in the room, worship God.
Worship the mighty God of Israel. Worship you, O God. Worship you, O God. Oh, mighty is our God. Mighty is our God. Zion, Bela, Leon, Dora, Bahia, Orelia, Sundeka, Nemaya. Oh, thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say Jesus.
Hallelujah.
I said somebody say Jesus.
Jesus.
I said somebody say Jesus.
Jesus. Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Jesus. 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 Oh, Jesus. Jesus.
We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus. We love you, Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
We love you, Father God.
We love you. We love you.
We love you,
Lord.
Mighty God.
We love you, Lord.
Woo! Hallelujah to your name. Hallelujah to your name. Hallelujah to your name.
Jesus.
Hallelujah to your name.
Jesus.
Hallelujah to your name.
Hallelujah
to your name, mighty God.
Glorious name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. 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 Oh, God, we worship you, oh God. We worship you, oh God.
Everybody in this church, grab hands for a minute. Everybody, grab hands. Everybody. If you're not holding a hand, grab one. If you're not holding hands, just grab a hand there. Woo, mighty God. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glorify your name. We glorify your name, mighty God. We glorify your name, mighty God. We did not come in this house to lift one another up. We came to worship you, Father God. We came to worship you. You do the lifting up, mighty God. You do the lifting up, mighty God. We did not come for man to be seen. We come for the power of the resurrection, mighty God. We came for the anointing. Father God, we came for the presence. We came for your glory. We came, Father God, that all of us may be touched. Not just one of us, but all of us, mighty mighty God, under the mighty hand of God. There's healing in the house. There's healing in the house. I said there's healing in the house. I said there's healing in the house. I said there's healing in the house. I feel the spirit of forgiveness. I feel the spirit of joy. I feel the spirit of God. The enemy is under our feet. Him for a minute. Somebody praise him for a minute. Somebody praise him for a second. Somebody praise him for a second. I said somebody praise him for a minute. I said somebody put your hands together and praise him for a minute. I'm too glorified. Praise him for a minute. Hey, you in the blue. You in the blue. Lift your hands up for a minute. I was praying for you at 3 o'clock in the morning the other morning. Praying for the whole family. And God spoke to me and said, son, I have stopped the hand of the enemy. He will not kill. He will not destroy. His assignment has been canceled. God's anointing is around you. The power of Jehovah Jireh is on you. God's anointing is on you. He's been on you since birth. The power of God. I have called you for such a moment as this. Somebody praise him for a minute. Somebody praise him for a second. This young lady here in the white, would you lift your hands up, hon? Ashley, lift your hands up. God spoke to me and said, son, she's weary in well-doing, but soon she's going to reap the harvest. God says there's been a heavy, heavy cloak of darkness around you and on you, but God said, I'm removing it this morning. God said, your feet are free, your hands are free, your spirit's free, and the joy of the Lord will be your rear guard. Praise him for a minute. Somebody praise him for a minute. Woo! Put your hands in the air, everybody. Say, I receive. I receive. I receive my healing. I receive my power. I receive my anointing. Praise it. Jesus. Jesus. Mighty God. I tell you, Jackie, according to what I've been reading in Scripture, they'd come in God's house and they'd worship for days. They'd praise for days. Glory to God. Say this with me. Say, I'm the temple of the Holy Spirit. And all my strength, all my might belongs to God. My heart belongs to Him. My soul belongs to him. My temple belongs to him. Give him praise for a minute. Woo! Jesus. Now in silence, please, with your one last time, with your hands lifted up and your eyes closed, please, in silence. Just for a moment. Just in silence for a moment. Just in silence for a moment. Young lady in black, right there. God is God. I said God. God. God has changed your whole destiny. Had it been not for God, sister, I'm going to tell you something. You wouldn't even be here right now. If it hadn't been for God's hand on your life, you would not be here but for God. But for God, I have changed your whole life and your whole destiny. I want your praise. I want your honor. I want you to praise me. I don't want you to seek me. I have pulled you out of the miry clay and put your feet on the mount to stay. Somebody praise him for a minute. Somebody praise him for a minute. Please, can I get everybody up here in the front? Please, come quickly. Everyone in the front, please come quickly. Everyone move in here. Squeeze into the front. Please, make room for her. Bring her right up. Everyone, please grab hands. Where'd Diane go? Do you got a word, Diane? I know I had more. I know there was more than just me.
Yes, it is.
Woo! Go ahead. Maybe.
Woo. Hallelujah. Taste and see that the Lord, he is good, and his mercy endureth forever. For the Lord, he is good, and his mercy endureth forever. Sorrow may come at night, but joy comes in the morning. For it is the joy of the Lord that is your strength. I say to you this day that the spirit of joy is going to break through in this place, saith God. Yay, saith God, the joy of the Lord, which is your strength, saith God, shall come upon this place in might and power by the Spirit of the living God. And there will be such joy, saith God, that you will not be able to contain it, saith God. For yea, saith the Lord, we are going out with joy, says the Lord. Hallelujah.
Joy of the Lord. 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 Somebody receive that. Joy of the Lord. Somebody say joy of the Lord. Somebody say joy of the Lord. Fill me full, mighty God. Mighty God. Mighty God. Come on, many are called, but few are chosen, guys. We're a chosen generation, a royal priesthood. Mighty Lord. Mighty Lord. Mighty Lord. Who's that mic? Give me that mic. Turn me on. I'm going to turn this mic on. Put your hands up. Somebody else has a word from the Lord. I feel another word. Ooh, I'll bring the mic right to you when you, whoever it is. Kind of know who it is, but they're not giving it. One more second. You got your own mic, go ahead.
I don't know if it's a word, but the Lord showed me that the glory cloud was resting over the church. And he showed me it opening up, and it was sprinkling over the church. Just a little bit. Not all, I don't think we could handle it all. But he was showing me that.
When he says that, he means rain is his spirit. The cloud is God's glory cloud, and it rains. He rains his spirit. That's what he's talking about. The rain of the spirit. Another person. Word from the Lord.
I had a vision last night which went along with what Danny said. In this vision, there was like spigots and water. Rain, water was just going. All these spigots, everywhere I looked, was just water coming out, water coming out.
Please, another second, please. I got such a powerful anointing on my wrist and my hands. I feel a powerful anointing on my hands. Please, with your hands lifted up and your eyes closed, just worship God for a moment. Worship God just for a moment. Just the way you're doing it right now. No louder than this. No louder than this. Say, here I am, Lord. Here I am, Lord. Say, here I am, Lord. Mighty God. Jesus. Glory to God. Here I am, mighty God. Now, with your eyes closed. If you're backslidden, I want you to hit the altar. If you've never accepted Jesus as your personal Savior, I want you to hit the altar and do it right now. We're going to pray over you. Do it right now. Do it right now. You feel God calling you back into his house. He's drawing you back. Just another moment. Right down there, the altar. A couple people are fighting it. Come quickly. Yep. Thank you, sister. Glory to God. Next. A couple more people. Two. I know there's two. Get some people praying for him, please. Glory to God. Two more. A couple more. There's been a cloud of defeat around him, and God's lifting it up off him. A cloud of defeat. That's a powerful, powerful thing when that thing tries to operate. Please, your eyes closed, please. Focus on God for a moment. God's lifting that cloud off him right now. God is lifting that cloud off of him right now. God is lifting that cloud off of him right now. Nobody touch him. Nobody touch him. God is lifting that cloud off of him right now as we speak. God is lifting the cloud off of him as we speak. God is lifting the cloud off of him as we speak. God is lifting the cloud off of him as we speak. Jesus. Lift it off, Father mighty God. Somebody give him praise for a minute while he's being touched and that cloud is lifting off of him. Somebody praise him for a minute. Somebody praise him for a minute. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, mighty God. Ooh, Jesus. If you've never been baptized in the Holy Spirit with the evidence of speaking in other tongues, hit the altar. God's going to do it right now. Hit the altar quickly. Mighty God. Young man, do you pray in the Spirit?
Good. Woo, Jesus, mighty God. You know, suicide's not the way out. It isn't. It's never been. You think it's rough here?
Hallelujah!
Mighty Savior. Zach, lay your hands on him. I don't know if he has the baptism or not, but lay your hands on him. If everyone in this room, if you do not have the baptism of the Holy Spirit, get to the altar right now. Get to the altar right now. Just come up for a refreshing if you want. But come quick before this whole order changes. Put your hands on him, brother. Pray over him. Jesus, mighty God. Sister Menard. Lay your hands back on him. Right here. Woo! Hey, look, the Bible says you'll receive healing as you pray. Somebody say, thank you, Lord. Somebody say, thank you, mighty God. Thank you, mighty God. With the blue thing on his back here. Eyes closed. Jesus. Mighty God. You never accepted Jesus as your personal Savior. You need to come right now and do it. If you've never came in front of people, said, Jesus, I want to make you the Lord of my life. I want you to come into my heart. I want you to do it right now. Glory to God. Woo. Other than you, is there somebody else in here that's pregnant? Other than her. That's obvious. Oh, yeah, okay. But is there somebody that nobody knows you're pregnant? Or do you just want nobody to know it? Grab hands, please. Pray as the brother's down there praying. He's before God right now. He's praying. Everybody grab hands. I want to see empty hands. I see empty hands. Grab hands. My mighty God. Touch him, Father God. Touch him, mighty God. Touch him, Lord. Touch him, Father. Mighty God. Touch him, Father. Touch him, Father. Say this with me as you got hands with every eye closed. Say, Father, remove the defeat off me. I will not be defeated. I will not be defeated. I can't hear you. I need to hear you out loud. Say, Father, remove this defeat off me. I will not be defeated. For thine is the kingdom. For thine is the kingdom. The power and the glory. Forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Jesus, glory, 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 getting hard to stand in here, getting hard to stand in here. Keep praying for him for a minute. Say, Father, we need you. Father, we need you. We need you to direct us, Father God. Direct our path, Lord Father. Direct our path. Nothing can come nigh our dwelling place. It's surrounded by blood. Nothing can come nigh my dwelling place. Surrounded by blood. I will not walk in fear. Say it with me. I will not walk in fear. Say it again. I will not walk in fear. I will not give the enemy a door. Yes. Yes, Lord. Woo, mighty God. What did you just say?
Direct my purpose.
Say it again.
God, direct my purpose.
Say it again.
God, direct my purpose.
Woo. Mighty God. Mighty God. Say it again. Say it again.
He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
Woo, mighty God, we worship you, Father. We worship you, mighty God. We worship you, Lord. Hold that mic, brother. Some people are going to start just saying two words. Just raise your hand if you got a word or two you want to shout out. He's going to put the mic in front of your mouth. Here comes Ted. Hold the mic for him, brother. Mighty God.
I saw your eyes as you walked
30
in
more
here.
Seconds.
Spirit said.
30 more seconds.
I have to say to you, brother, it's good to see you here. Brother, it's good to see you here.
Because he gave us your son.
Yeah.
One last one. Right here. She has the black and the gold on.
The Lord is the light of my salvation. Whom shall I fear?
Hallelujah. Woo.
Father.
Thank you, Lord.
One more up here.
This is something that the Lord told me a long time ago, and I didn't say it. And it's come around again, and I didn't say it. And I'm starting to beat Peter's record of denying and doing that stuff. So it's a record I don't want to break. But he said that what he's done for us, and he sacrificed for us, and his death and his pain, and all of that stuff that he did for it, wasn't about his death. It wasn't about him getting the glory. It wasn't about him getting the throne or the kingdom or sitting at East. All that stuff that he did for us, and what he told me was, all I want back for those sacrifices is just you. And that's what it was all about. And then he said that I'm the king and I'm your example and I taught you by example. And he expects us to love one another and do for one another and sacrifice for one another. And like the king taught us. And then he said, when you get to the point where you can sacrifice for your brothers and sisters right up to giving your life, then say in your heart with a true heart that all I want back is just you. And when you get to that point, then you've summed up the whole word of God in just one word, and that's agape, the love that Christ taught.
Thank you, Mighty God. Ooh, Jesus. Thank you, Mighty God. Man, I feel the baptism of the Holy Spirit all over her. I feel the presence of God all over her. Whew. Jesus. Mighty God. Bring her up here. Let me just lay hands on her up here. You can be seated. Thank you. Whew. Jesus, mighty God. Jesus. Okay.
Okay, testing, like, I don't know how long I've been going. Y'all probably heard this already, how long I've been going. Couldn't see it. I could sit back in the back of the church and couldn't even read the sign up here. That's how long my eyes were just that bad. And when I had the surgery, I can read that sign without glasses at all. That's just how powerful God really is. I can see. I only wear them now if I had to read a little bit of reading. But I can see better now than anything. But then what I really wanted to say is Pastor Terry called us up here this Sunday. It's for those who had a bad back. Years ago, I can say 20-some years ago, I ripped every muscle in my back completely out. They didn't do surgery on it because they didn't want to do exploratory surgery, which they didn't know exactly what was wrong with it. Over the years, it got worse. It got worse. Sometimes I get up, my back be hurting me so bad, I don't know what to do. Couldn't pick up nothing. He called me up and said, who wants to do surgery? I mean, pray over. He prayed over it. Believe me or not, I haven't had a pain since he prayed over it. I haven't had a pain. I mean, I get a little stiffness, but I can walk, pick up things. I say, something that simple. I say, first you did my eyes, and my back been hurt. My back been bothering me for, I would say, at least 20-some years. Because they say, older you get, that's what arthritis try to hit when you got an injury. Heck, I'm about to tell arthritis, goodbye. Don't come back. Like I said, my back is excellent. So,
Ephesians 1, starting, Jackie, in verse 18. Once you read 18, then we're going to go down through 23. But when he flips to 19, don't read it.
The eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that ye may know what is the hope of his calling, and what
Stop.
The...
Lift your hands up here. You're going to let me preach, and you know you need hands laid on you, and I can't go any further until you do. Whoever you are, get in the center aisle. Move now. Come on, come on, come on. If you ever minister, and you're ministering under the anointing, if you are not supposed to go forward, there's like a wall. And the wall was not, there was people that I had to lay hands on. And there's nobody else, correct? No one else? You, stand up, lift your hands up. Get up. Whew, man, I'm telling you, there's a powerful, powerful, powerful anointing up here. Where did I just get this from? Whew, Jesus. Please, with your hands lifted up, your eyes closed, please. Okay, three people, right? First. Call out while you're up here. You're back? Did you just hear that testimony? I normally don't let people give testimonies before a service, but the Lord told me to do that. Would you move up to the platform, please? While you're here? While you're here? You're back? Move to the platform. Okay, that's good. Have her turn face. Lift your hands up, eyes closed. You believe God can heal you? Do you believe when I lay my hands on you, God's going to heal your back? What? Tell me what was wrong with your back. Lift your hands up. Tell me what was wrong with your back. It does, gives you pain all the time. You believe that when I touch you, God's going to heal you? Because healing comes through the hands. Everyone in this church, lift your hands up. I want every eye closed. I want to hear anything from anyone. Nothing. You stand perfectly still. Is there anyone in this room that is there anyone in the room that has polyps? Say this with me. Say bye.
Bye.
His stripes
I
have been, I said have been,
made
whole.
In Jesus' name,
I
am
healed
by
the power
of the resurrection,
by the laying on
of hands.
In Jesus' name.
Walk her around a little bit up here.
Yes, ma'am.
Wasn't there three?
You believe when I lay hands on you, God's going to stand still for a minute. You believe that when I lay hands on you, God's going to heal you, correct?
Yes.
Jackie, when she hits you, then get her. Lay your hand on her back. In the back, lift your hands up, close your eyes, hands over your head. Oh, really? You believe when I lay hands on you, God's going to heal you? You do? In Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Thank you, Father God. I just felt something. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name. Walk him around a little bit. How you doing there? How you doing? Put your hands up. Jackie, come around the front of her. Up her. Whew! Mighty God. Lay your hand on her forehead. Are you up here for prayer? Wait, what for? Oh, the polyps? You got the polyps? Where they at? Really? Lift your hands up. You're the one with the polyps. I didn't even know what polyps are. The only reason I know what polyps are is because I had them on my throat. Three times. So how long have you known that? You believe God can heal you right now? In other words, remove the polyps, right? In Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Is any tumors? Does anybody have a tumor? What's a tumor? That's not a polyp, is it? Oh, so tumor is what? Oh. Thank you, Lord. Okay, guys, now I can go ahead. Thank you, guys. Okay, Ephesians chapter 1. Did you read 18 or did you even get a chance to read 18?
I didn't get through it.
Oh, you didn't? Well, go ahead and get through it.
The eyes of your understanding being enlightened.
Say my eyes. Say my eyes. Lift your hands up and say, my eyes,
mine,
go.
That ye may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints.
Now, verse 19. And what is the exceeding greatness of his power? What is the exceeding greatness of his power to us word who believe? Say, I'm a believer.
I'm a believer.
Please say, I'm a believer. Everyone in the church say, I'm a believer.
I believe.
I believe.
I believe.
I said, I believe.
I believe.
I believe. I believe in his power towards me because I'm a believer. According to the working of his mighty power, verse 20, which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead. Say, Christ is raised from the dead. Say it again. Christ is raised from the dead. And he is my Savior. He's my power. He's my might. He moves on me in hours of darkness.
which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead, set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places. Look at your person next to you and say, I believe I'm there. Say it again. I believe I'm there. Now I want you to turn to Colossians 1:18 for a moment. Follow me, please. Man, I'm going to tell you guys, I feel such power in my hands. I like to come down there and just take my hand, and I feel such power in my hand. I can, like, I want to force it, push it through you. I've never felt anything like that. Go, Jackie.
And he is the head of the body, the
He's
church.
He's the head of the body, the church. Say, I'm the church.
I'm the church.
Say, I'm the church. And I've got the resurrected power. Somebody's going to get healed in here right now. Say, I am the church. The church. The church. And I have the power. 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 Somebody wake up and say that.
And I
have the power. I have the glory.
I have the power.
God's glory abides over me. By his stripes, I have been made whole. Somebody praise him for a minute. Excuse me, brother. Turn that furnace up to 72, will you? People in here are freezing. 2 Corinthians 5:21. Say 2 Corinthians 5:21.
For we know that our earthly house...
2 Corinthians 5:21.
For he hath made him to be sin for us.
He made him to be sin. Say this with me. Say the sin... He took in his body. He did not wear it. He took it. Took the sin in his body. Who knew no sin. That I might be made the righteousness of God in him. Say, I have the power of God. Say it again. I have the power of God. Say it again. I have the power of God. Say, God is my rest period. Say it again. God is my rest period. I have the power of God. He said, say this with me, he said, God said, say unto this mountain, and it will move. Put your hands in the air. You got a mountain in your life? Command it out of your life. Say, I command in the name of Jesus Christ, the Almighty God, King of heaven and earth, ruler of all divine powers. I command in his name that every mountain, every principality, every spirit in high places, remove yourself, because here I come. Somebody praise him for a minute. Colossians chapter 2, verse 15. 2:15.
And having spoiled...
And having what?
Spoiled.
Having what?
Spoiled.
The way we say it in the South is "rent." Anybody talk like that? Anybody use that? You do? "Rent." Say "rent." Spoiled. "Rent." "Rent." You "rent" principalities. Destroyed them. I have spoiled principalities and powers. He made a show of them openly. Say openly.
Openly.
Say openly.
Openly.
And he did what? Triumphing over them in it. In what? The spoil. Say he spoiled him. Say he whooped him good. Say he whooped him good. Say he whooped him good. So what he did was took the sin, and then he removed the sin, got rid of it, and now he says, I turn the power over to the church. Romans 6:16. Would you read that, please? Romans 6:16.
Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey, his servants ye are to whom ye obey, whether of sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness?
Say this with me as your hands are lifted up. Father,
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 we submit,
submit,
submit our will, ourselves, over to you. Jesus, you are our King. Jesus, you are our Lord, and by your strength, by your power, by your faith, by your anointing, we will conquer. Get up and give him praise for a minute. Luke 10:19. Would you read that, please? Luke 10:19. I'm going to tell you something. Something's getting ready to happen in here. Something's getting ready to happen in here, man. I feel like, you know what I feel like doing? If I could fly, I'd take off flying right now. But I can't fly.
Behold, I give unto you.
Gives unto who?
Me.
Who? 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 Me. He gives unto me. See, you got to make this stuff personal. People don't make this personal. They read it and they go, that's for him. No, it's not for him. You're the minister. So are you. You're a minister too. But I'm not supposed to be preaching. Yeah, you are. You're supposed to preach the gospel to every living creature. Every living creature. Behold, I give unto you power. Say power.
Power.
Say power.
Power.
Holy Spirit power.
Holy Spirit.
Holy Ghost power.
Holy Ghost power.
Holy Ghost power.
Holy Ghost
power.
To tread.
Tread. Show them the bottom of them tennis shoes you got on. Them are treaders right there, buddy. I give you power to tread on all serpents. Well, the first thing you have to understand, you can't be afraid of them. Say, I'm not afraid. Say, I'm not afraid. If we're afraid, if we're afraid of Satan to the most that we're afraid of snakes, we're in trouble. To tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Say enemy.
Enemy.
Say enemy.
Enemy.
Look at somebody saying, oh, I don't know about the enemy. You got an enemy. If you're a Christian, you got an enemy knocking at your front door. Say enemy. Say, I got the power over the enemy. He will not defeat my family. He will not kill my family. And he cannot touch my finances. Get him, praise him for a minute. Over all the power of the enemy and nothing by any means. Say nothing. Say nothing. Nothing. Say that means nothing. Have you ever ran into nothing before? It means nothing. Nothing. Nothing can harm you. Say amen.
Amen.
Say, I receive that.
I receive that.
Say, I receive that.
I receive that.
Colossians 3:13, read that. 3:13, stick with me, guys.
Forbearing one another and forgiving
what?
One another.
What?
Forbearing.
What?
Forbearing one another and forgiving one another. If any man have a quarrel against any. Even as Christ forgave you, so also do ye.
Now, what I need you to do real quick, I want you to, if you can get up and do this with your strength, I want you to go shake three people's hands and say, I forgive you. Go do it right now. This has got to do with the power. Go do it right now. Go do it right now. Don't sit and look at me. Go do it right now. Three people. Say, I forgive you. Say, I forgive you. Three people. Do it now. Three people. Shake. Three people. Now, wait a minute. You got to go get three more. Go. Three more. I forgive you. I forgive you. This is the power of God. I forgive you. Now, wait a minute. The last person you shake their hand, say this to them. Say, without you, I have no power. Say it again. Without you, I have no power. For where two or more are gathered together, in his name, there he is. Colossians 1:13.
Forbearing one another and forgiving one another.
Colossians 1:13. 1:13. There you go.
Who hath delivered us.
Who have what?
Delivered
He's
us.
He's what?
Delivered
He's done what?
Delivered us.
What did he do?
Delivered
who?
Me.
Delivered me. He delivered me from the power of darkness. Say darkness.
Darkness.
And he's translated me into the kingdom of his dear son. And there I will operate. Say it again. And there I will operate. Operate. Get your hands in there. Say I will operate under the power of God. Under the anointing of God. And I will do my part to stop the hand of the enemy, to break his power and his dominion. Give him praise. Ephesians 6:18. Ephesians 6:18.
Praying always with all prayer and supplication.
Say, I must do my part in prayer. Praying always with prayer and supplication in the Spirit. Not in the flesh, in the Spirit, in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance, supplication for all saints, verse 19. And for me, say, for the pastor, lift your hands up, say, and for the pastor, the utterance, preaching word may be given unto him that he may open his mouth boldly to make known the mysteries of the kingdom. That's my job. Say, that's my job. Say, and I receive it in Jesus' name. John 14, 16 and 17. Stand to your feet when you read this one, Jackie. Matthew 4, or John 14, 16 and 17.
And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter.
He did. Say, Jesus did. Say, Jesus prayed to the Father, and he did. He gave the Comforter, the Holy Spirit. Say, Comforter, that he may, he may abide with you for how long? For how long? Forever. Verse 17, even the Spirit of Truth. Say, the Spirit of Truth. Say, that I have the Spirit of Truth. Say it again, I have the Spirit of Truth. Say, not by my might, nor by power, but by the Spirit of Truth, that the world cannot see, because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but ye know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be on your outside, on your head,
in you,
on your feet, in me. Say, in me. Say, the third part of the Godhead is in this room right now. He's here inside me right now. He's in this room right now. John 15, 26. John 15, 26.
But when the Comforter is come.
The Comforter, he came. Say, he came. Say, he came. He came. He's the Comforter. He's the Comforter. I cannot blame you. I have forgiven you. He's the Comforter. He came to comfort me. Finish it.
Whom I will send unto you from the Father.
From
the Father.
The Father. Say, the Father.
The Father.
Heard a prayer.
Heard a prayer.
From Jesus Christ.
From Jesus Christ.
That he would send the Comforter. And he did. Even the Spirit of Truth, which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of George. He shall testify of the pastor. He shall testify of Adam. He shall testify of Sister Harper. No, he said he will testify of me, Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ. When you don't hear preaching about him, we're in trouble. John 16, 7. Isn't that right? John 16, 7. That's where all the power is at in his name. I said, that's where all the power is at in his name. Go.
Nevertheless, I tell you the truth.
I'm not lying to you. I'm telling you the truth. Say the truth.
The truth.
I'll set you free. Say the truth. We'll set you free.
We'll set you free.
Go.
It is expedient for you that I go
fast. I have to leave, Jesus said. I have to go fast. I got to go quick. I cannot tarry. I cannot linger. The Comforter will come unto you. He will. But if I don't depart, I will send. If I depart, I will send him unto you. He came. Say, he came. John 16, 13 and 14. Stick with me. John 16, 13 and 14. Read it, Jake.
Howbeit, when he, the Spirit of truth, is come, he will guide you into all truth.
He will do what?
Guide you into
guide,
all truth.
Say he's a guide. He's a guide. Say he's a guide. He's a guide. You don't have to pay for this guide. He's a guide. He's free. He will guide you into all truth. Say all truth.
All truth.
Say all truth.
All truth.
Well, you don't know the truth. It's because you're not hanging around the one that has the truth. Say he's the truth.
He's the truth.
He must, shall not speak of who?
Himself.
He doesn't talk about himself. Say the Holy Spirit don't talk about itself. Lift your hands up for a minute. I'm trying to teach you something. This is powerful. Because I've heard people in this very church do this. Holy Spirit, we worship you. No, you don't ever worship the Holy Spirit. He says, I will guide you into all truth, for he shall know and speak of himself. For he shall not speak of himself. But whatever he hears from heaven and from this, he's going to talk about. Say, he's going to talk about. Say, I have the Holy Spirit, and he's powerful. Finish it.
And he will show you things to come.
He'll show you what?
Things to come.
Show you what?
Things to come.
Wait a minute. Show you what?
Things to come.
Things to come where? In the church? Yeah. Things to come where? In the world? That's what he does. And people think that's a downer. That's not a downer. When you hear a word from a prophet and he tells you something that is going to happen and it don't look good, it came straight from the throne. It came from God. God sent the word. Man didn't send the word. God sent the word. So what the Holy Spirit does? He says, I'm going to show you a thing that's going to take place. Miraculously take place. How many of you guys want to know what's going to take place? How many of you going to find out? How many of you going to find out? Everybody ought to have their hand raised up and said, I'm going to find out. John 8, 26. Keep following me. John 8, 26.
I have many things to say and to judge of you, but he that sent me is true.
He's what?
True.
Yeah.
And I speak to the world those things which I have heard of him.
That's all he wants to talk about. It seems like that's all the Holy Spirit wants to talk about. Is Jesus. Is God. That's all he wants to talk about all the time. 1 Corinthians 14, 14. 1 Corinthians 14, 14. And then we'll start the message. 14, 14.
For if I pray in an unknown tongue, my spirit prayeth.
Put your hands up and say, I pray. I love to pray. Say, I love to pray.
I love to pray.
Say, the Holy Spirit leads me in prayer.
The Holy Spirit leads me.
Say, the Holy Spirit leads me in prayer.
The Holy Spirit leads me in prayer.
Say it again. The Holy Spirit leads me in prayer.
The Holy Spirit leads me in prayer.
You see where we're missing it, right? He said, I'm going to tell you of things to come. The whole church ought to have a word when we come in here together. Pastor Mark, guess what? The Lord showed me a vision last night. Here's what he showed me. You can have an open vision. He said, I've come to tell you the truth. I've come to tell you the truth. Read that to him again. 14, 14.
For if I pray in an unknown tongue, my spirit prayeth, but my understanding is unfruitful.
Well, you're sitting around praying in the spirit. Ask God, what am I praying about? You might be praying about somebody that's over in Russia. Who knows what you're praying about? You might be praying to stop an atom bomb attack. Who knows what you're praying about? You might be praying and you might wake up the next day and find out that somebody didn't die because you got to pray in the middle of the night because he woke you up because the power's inside you and you went, wow, what am I praying about? Well, let's see what took place. Praise God. Say, praise God.
Praise God.
Somebody praise him for a minute. Let me get this together here. So there's this bold man, and I'm going to read a couple of things that he said to you. Here's what he said. I'm going to get him to tell you who it is. You go home and figure it out on your own. Here's what he said about the Bible. Praying through the Holy Spirit, the one that God sent us. He said, revelation is the meaning of life. The nature of God is right in his word. Well, you'll never know that if you don't pray and find that out. You're never going to know about nothing about God's nature. You can read things in the scripture about it. It's filled with it. But to really understand his holiness, lift your hands up and close your eyes. Say, to understand his holiness. I got to go into that place of holiness where it's just me and him, him and I, praying all alone to get a revelation. He says, God shows us his nature. He says he shows us his peace, his salvation, and it comes from his word. Our devotion should be towards God so we can find out what's happening in the last hour. Say, I want to know what's going on in the last hour. This guy, I don't know who this guy was, but this guy said this a long time ago. If you want to know who this was, I'll tell you later. This guy said this years ago. He said, the strength of myself in the country we live in is from our religious convictions. Could you imagine if we had the conviction to all pray? Let's say we all came together and prayed for 2-3 hours a day. We had that conviction to do that. Could you imagine what we could change? Same guy said this. He said, the foundations of our society, our government, rest upon the teachings of the Word of God. The teachings of the Word of God. Could you imagine if we all came together with a song and a hymn and a teaching together, the focus and the power we could have going forward? My. I don't know. You think we could? I think you could probably start out like a little snowball in prayer, and it would get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. Exodus says that. Matthew says that. Isaiah says that. And Paul even said it. He said, if you would start out in prayer to get bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger. If you don't have a moral belief or you don't have a spiritual belief behind you, grab someone that does and let them lay hands on you. But Pastor Mark, I don't pray. Learn how to pray. But Pastor Mark, I really, it's hard for me to pray. Go find yourself a closet and stick yourself in it and pray. Lift your hands up. The hour's coming where we're going to have to pray. It's here right now. We're going to have to pray. Say, I pray. And I want to hold fast by the power of God, the beliefs, the principles, the laws that are written in Scripture. I want to hold them fast. Say, hold them fast. So God's word can be an anchor for my emotions. Anchor for my emotions. That's what anchors the church. Prayer, the Word of God, anchors our soul down so it doesn't, we don't run off with emotion. Emotion. The world's going to kill me. This is going to happen. That's going to happen. Emotions run wild when you have nothing to anchor it with. So you anchor it with Scripture. I anchor myself with Scripture. Through prayer and understanding of who God is and what he is, and it becomes a precept for my heart. It never changes. Say, never changes. And then, say this with me, and then I'm guided, directed through the future. You have something to hang on to, something that directs you. Say, directs me. Directs your path. Say, it directs my path. Guides me. And brings me all into all righteousness. All righteousness. Because the church of the living God has become tired, exhausted. We've not been a guiding light. We've not been the source of peace. We've not been the source of joy. Put your hands up, please, and your eyes closed. Father, in the name of Jesus, mighty God, before we change this service, those that do not have peace, Father God, I want you to fill them with peace. If they couldn't, if they didn't sit in this service today and didn't get something out of the service, Jackie, somebody spiritually did. I want you to say this with me. My joy comes from God. Not the world. Not what the world can buy me. Not what the world can give me. Not even what I've lost. God is my joy. God is my compass. He keeps me straight in life. Keeps me headed towards the throne. Keeps my feet straight. Keeps my mind straight. Keeps my home straight. Keeps my family straight if I'll pray for them. Kids. Keeps my kids straight. Without that guiding light, without that guiding arrow, we're lost. Say lost. Say this with me, Father. I want to step up to the plate. Woo! I want to step up to the plate. And I want to make myself available to pray and to seek your face. To lift up first those that are in rule over us. And to lift up God's body. I want to make myself available right now. And I'm not going to ask, Father God, how can I fit you in? You're going to be number one. And all the other stuff in my life is going to have to be fitted in around you. Father God, I step up to the plate right now. Say it again. Father God, I step up to the plate right now. And I make myself available. In Jesus' mighty name. In Jesus' mighty name, I make myself available. How many of you are available? Stand up and let me finish praying this over you. Then you can do communion and you can go. Lift your hands up. Let me pray over you. Father, in the name of Jesus, when darkness comes and tries to stop what they've committed to, when the enemy tries to stop it, you stop him, Father God. We just make a stand. And this is the hour that we're going to do it, or the time we're going to do it. Because we, the first church, will be a place of prayer, not a place for a place of den and thieves, or a place of thieves. But a place of prayer, sacrifice, and I make myself available to it right now. Say, I make myself available to it right now. I want to hear you say that out loud. Lift your hands up, say, I make myself available. Whether it be 3 in the morning, 4, 5, 6, whatever the time is, you're not going to be fitted in. I'm going to fit everything else around you. Father, I receive the call right now. Father, I receive the call right now. The call of prayer. And now Pastor Mark is dumping something else on us. He is calling me to be a person of prayer and fasting. For this is the hour of darkness. And I must operate in prayer and fasting. 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 Some of you can take a 3-day fast and you can stop whatever you want to stop. Some of you can take a week fast and stop whatever you can stop. Some of you can take 1 day and stop whatever you stop. Do it now. Do it now. Some of you pray. No, we're all going to do this together as a team. Say as a team.
As a team.
Say it again, as a team.
As a team.
Now I want everybody from today forward, from this Sunday, today, say today.
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 Right now. Until next Sunday. Until next Sunday. That will be a time of fasting for me. Say fasting.
Fasting.
And in that fast,
I
am going to read Ephesians chapter 3 and 4, 5 and 6 during the fast. During the fast.
During the fast.
today until next Sunday. I make myself available for the fast. No matter where I'm at, 100 miles from here, 50 miles from here, wherever I'm at, I'm making myself available for this fast. Give God praise for a moment. Keep your hands up. Now I want you to say this with me. Say, what am I fasting for? Anybody want to know? I already told you. Get a tape and find out what it was. Did you get it? He said anything good. That'd be a big general fast. We've got to focus. We're focused on something. We're focused on something. What did I tell you to pray for? Our leaders, includes me, and the body. So if I ask you to pray for it, I want you to fast for it, but I want you to put a B part on your fast. Say B part. On the fast. I'm going to pray that God's house, his place of worship, this place, not really a house, but his place of worship, right in here. Now don't get deep on me. Oh, we're worshiping. Yeah, we know that. I'm just generalizing. Our place of worship, we worship God, that we make it a place where God's glory can be. Say, I'm doing that right now. How many of you are with me? Lift your hands up. Good, good, good. Okay. You can have a seat. It's time for communion. I'm glad you do, brother. Oh, you got that right. Isn't that the truth?
Yeah.
Jesus. Man, oh man. Jesus.
While we're waiting for them to get the communion, can everyone stand? Father God, we want to get our hearts right this morning.
Yes.
We just thank you, Lord,
yes,
first for your word that went forth. Father, let this word just penetrate our hearts, Lord. Let us change, Lord. Let us make you our first priority. Father, let this body be the one that when Jesus returns, that he says, well done, my good and faithful servants. So get our hearts right this morning, Father, as we take up communion. We do it unto you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. If you have accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, you may come up now and receive communion.
Jesus.
anybody in here facing jail time, or you got somebody that's facing jail time? Come on down here front. I think there's more than you. Who is it? Yes. Solomon, you mean? Father, in the name of Jesus, mighty God, have your way, Lord, Father God. Move on them, Lord, Father, and if they do face that time, Lord, Father God, let them go into a place where there's ministers. Any false word that's said against any of them, we break that in Jesus' mighty name. We take authority over it in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, guys.
Over 2,000 years ago, I'm sorry.
Got a new purse.
Over 2,000 years ago, God saw that we needed a Savior because we couldn't save ourselves. So He sent His one and only Son. And today, we still need Him. In John 10:10, Jesus said, He came that we may have life and have it more abundantly. He gives us life through the Holy Spirit. And with this abundant life comes hope, healing, deliverance, provision, protection, and freedom. When we accept Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, we have the assurance that by His death on the cross and His resurrection, through faith and believing in Him, we are forgiven. We are redeemed, we have peace and riches, and the hope of eternal life. Christ was handed over to die because of our sins, and He was raised to life to make us right with God. Because it cost Him His life, we get to live. As we take up this bread, which represents His body, and drink of His blood. Heavenly Father, we thank You that even while we were still sinners, You sent Your Son to die for us. And we thank You, Lord Jesus, that there is no need to have goats and animals and birds sacrifices anymore, because You sacrificed Your life for us. You came down from glory. Became poor so that we could be rich and that we could have eternal life. We thank You, Lord Jesus, we thank You for the sacrifice that You made for us. You paid for us with Your body. You took the stripes. You took the bruises. You took the humiliation, the shame. You hung on that cross in our place. And for this, we say thank You. We thank You for saving us. And we take of your body in your precious name. And this cup, it's not the cup of blood from animals, but it's your blood that came from the thorns in your head, the nail prints in your hand and your feet, from your pierced side. This blood covers us and protects us. This blood makes us righteous. This blood makes us holy. This blood forgives us for our sins. This is the blood that ran down Emmanuel's veins. And now it flows through us. Lord Jesus, we will not take this lightly. But we will remember the sacrifice that you made for us. And we drink of your blood now in your holy name. Amen.
Is Jesse still in? Don't nobody leave yet, guys. Somebody just told me that you got a song or something. Is she still in here or no? Would you just, can Diane get that baby? Or get that baby, brother. Just stand there with your hands lifted up for a minute. I just want to pray over you. You've really been in my spirit lately. A little over a month. And I was just kept praying for you and praying for you. And God started talking to me about your strength and joy and presence of God. How the enemy wants to defeat you. He wants to take the joy from you. He wants to remove the joy. But we're not going to let him do it. Because you belong to God. And God began to show me as I was praying for you the warring spirit that he's placing inside you. I said the warring spirit that he's placed inside you. Power of God. For yea, the Lord says, I've brought you this way for a purpose, for a divine reason. My presence has brought you from point A to point B. And I'm going to give you the strength to finish the course that I've laid before you. Thank you, Father. Thank you. Thank you, honey. Okay, now you wanted to, somebody had a, man, that's all I can say to you. No, there's more. This little guy right here, I think. Isn't it him? Michael?
Yo.
You wrote it?
I ain't new to this. This is the song I wrote.
You're not new to this, what? Rap?
I ain't new to this. Yeah, well, you know, what God had me doing, you know, even though I haven't been up here, that don't mean I don't know what I'm doing. So, yeah, I got Demario with me.
Can't hear you, brother.
Hello?
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 Tap on it.
It's on, brother. Take off.
Yeah.
You doing this by yourself or you want help? You want me to help you?
I got DeMario.
Yo.
Since I have God by my side, you know I'm about gonna murder this. People looking at me thinking I'm just another kid, but I'm about to pop this lid
and go in.
I'm shining like a diamond cause God's glory is over me. God's coming back, I ain't lying. If you don't believe me, just wait and see.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Who's knocking at the door? I can't wait to go to heaven cause I really wanna make some s'mores with Jesus. I ain't new to this.
Got Jesus on my side and I feel I'm about to kill his soul.
I ain't new to this.
Got Jesus on my side and I feel I'm about to kill his soul.
I ain't new to this.
Hey, what you say?
I ain't new to this.
Hey, what you say?
I ain't new to this.
Hey, what you say?
I ain't new to this. Hey.
Hey.
Hey. I don't play, I do this every day. It don't matter what you say, cause God's leading my way. I won't go astray, I can't promise that, but I know if I do, He'll bring me back. God saved me from my sins, saved me,
He'll save you. I was at church one Sunday and I saw the mystery like Scooby-Doo.
Back to back, bad. I feel like I'm Liza Bell. He built me up and put me together. His glory reigns forever and ever. I ain't new to this.
Got Jesus on my side and I feel I'm about to kill his soul.
I ain't new to this.
Got Jesus on my side and I feel I'm about to kill his soul.
I ain't new to this.
Hey, what you say?
I ain't new to this.
Hey, what you say, Mike?
I ain't new to this.
Hey, what you say?
I ain't new to this. Hey. It don't matter where you've been at, it don't matter where you're coming from. The only thing you need is know that Jesus is the only one. I'm vicious like a lion, I ain't even trying. I'm sighing, I'm crying, I feel like I'm dying. I'll meet you Mount Zion, hey. This stuff is easy to me, it's like ABC. My faith is the only time I ADD. This stuff is killing me, but in a good way, the Holy Spirit gives me the word
to say.
Bow my head and hope to pray that Jesus coming back another day. I ain't new to this.
Got Jesus on my side and I feel I'm about to kill his soul.
I ain't new to this.
Got Jesus on my side and I feel I'm about to kill his soul.
I ain't new to this.
Hey, what you say, Mike?
I ain't new to this.
Hey, what you say, Mike?
I ain't new to this.
Hey, what you say, Mike?
I ain't new to this. Hey.
Thank you, Lord. You wrote that? That's good, bro.
Coffee up, Pastor Mark said, I want to do music. I said, what? He said, all right. And he heard a song, and all of a sudden he was riding along with the
voice. You know, brother, I used to take a lot of heat for letting you do that. When you were rapping, I used to take a lot of heat. I'd tell him, look, you could be doing it in a bar. I'd rather do it here in the church than do it in the bar. God bless you. That was good, brother. Just make sure you keep God in the center of it and keep your hands up. Tell them what I mean, brother, when you go back there.
That's your job. Hey. That's your job. You better do it. You've been goofed off long enough.